Yesterday, the Senate approved President Muhammad Buhari's request for a loan of $850 billion to fund the 2020 budget, which is threatened by the falling price of crude, to fight and also to fight the COVID-19 pandemic. Joining us is the Chairman, Senate Committee on Appropriation, Senator Barau Jibrin. As much as we understand the urgency, people are worried that the federal government is borrowing.
Let me clear the air on what was requested for by Mr. President. You see, the request, the loan you're talking about, has been approved sometime before now. What was requested by Mr. President is the borrowing mix, that is, changing the amount to be borrowed externally, that is, giving more, asking that the borrowing should be more internally rather than having more borrowed externally. So this is what happened. It's not as if it was a new request. It's not at all.
Okay.
It was a request before now.
Okay, point taken. We've been getting quite a bit of money recently from EU. We just heard yesterday that Germany also sends about 2.2 billion naira money from Africa Development Bank. Quite a bit of funds have come into Nigeria. What's the National Assembly doing to ensure that these monies are appropriately spent for the right purpose?
Hmm. You see, we have a very, very established system, financial system in this country.
Right.
And I want to tell you, it's one of the best in the whole world.
Okay.
When this money is coming, this is a mere pronouncement. And when they come in, they're going into the consolidated revenue fund of the government. And they will not be spent until they have been appropriate. I mean, until they go through the process of appropriations. So there's nothing to worry about all this money is coming in. Once they come in, as I said, they were going straight into the consolidated revenue fund in line with the provision of our constitution.
Right.
And once a dime, a cobra is going to be spent, it has to be brought to the National Assembly for appropriation.
Yesterday at the plenary, the Speaker, Honorable Gbajabi Amila, was saying that this is a rare opportunity for us to fix things, paraphrasing now, that we must cut the cost of governance drastically, and we must begin to see what we can do to fix our economy. Could you tell us a bit about what exactly was agreed, and were there the specified steps? Okay, you know this, and specified steps on what we can do to ensure that we can cut cost of governance across board to make more funds available for us to use.
This has been in the forefront of our objectives in the National Assembly as a whole, to make sure that we cut cost of governance. An ongoing process, we are doing that, we are looking at that, to make sure that we cut cost of running our government.
All right. Amidst this borrowing, we are borrowing so much right now, and my fear is that we are sinking every day into debt, and I do not know how we plan to come out of it. So is there any plan somewhere among the lawmakers? Is there anything you guys are working on to ensure that you increase our revenue after COVID-19? Is there any plan on ground for post-COVID-19?
Let me tell you, you must borrow. You must borrow to develop your infrastructures. You must borrow to create a enabling environment for the private sector to thrive. If you don't do that, you go nowhere. All nations that are successful did the same thing, almost did the same thing. This is the system. This is the model.
Okay.
It's very, very important. And you need to, if you don't borrow, your economy will become stagnant, and it will be, you create a doom scenario in the country.
I need to ask you about Kano, because you're from Kano.
Yes.
Kano State has a huge population. Do you have an idea of what the government could be planning to ensure that their state is not so hit as a result of this reduction of revenue coming in, because we don't really see any major idea from that state?
Well, you see, the effect of COVID-19 pandemic, is something that is going to affect, or is affecting, every country, every subnational, and cannot be an exception. But the only thing is that we have a governor in Kano who is very, very proactive, who is alive to his duties, and he has started already to see how you can look inwards to that it mitigates the effect of COVID-19 pandemic on the economy of Kano. You know, Kano is the commercial nerve center of the entire northern Nigeria. No state in the north that does not have one thing or the other compared to Kano commercially or even politically. So, and Kano is playing that very role under the administration of the present governor. is doing very well, very, very proactive. And I can show you.
You keep using the word proactive. That word proactive.
Because this in the paper this morning, I read the Kano State governor asking for help from the federal government and everybody, saying that they are having challenge with the traditional system. People have a traditional disbelief concerning this disease. So, and this is not a new thing. Like, Lagos shut down 6 weeks ago.
So when you say proactive.
So when we say proactive, and we're just having a shutdown imposed by the federal government when people died last week. So I'm wondering, how do you, sir, define being proactive?
Thank you.
My God,